Hi, it's Bobby Liebling from Pentagram, and we're sitting around here roasting in the heat, and we're at South by Southwest down here in Austin, Texas. We finally passed the audition, like John Lennon said once upon a time, a long time ago. I'm not a master of ceremonies. I'm just a class clown, but it's fun. It's still fun. When it gets up there, it becomes, yeah.
How'd you come up with your stage performance as far as facial expressions and gestures?
He gives me a yin yang thing, and when I'm playing with him, I've got the confidence to be goofy or be mean or be whatever I want to be. I know what expression he's giving me as to whether I'm, you know, pulling it off good or I'm kind of a stinkeroo, you know? Some nights are better than others.
I heard you guys are trying to pick a name. You first thought of Pentagram, then went through a bunch of other names.
Oh, that was years and years ago. Yeah. Oh, my God. The very beginning, yeah, it was just a very short process in time. I don't even consider those names. I mean, we went through Pentagram, and then it was called Virgin Death for a month, and then Wicked Angel for about a month and a half. This is all, you know, BS.
The capper, as far as like rejoining on a permanent basis, was just the fact that, you know, Bobby getting his life together personally.
A lot of demons,
and you know, all that stuff. You know, we tried all that stuff for so long in the 80s and half the 90s. As well as like, you know, all the occult symbols that go along with it, and none of it ever got us anywhere. Yeah. Now look what's happened, man. I mean, it's like there's very few bands, man, in history, I'm sure, you know, who start to escalate in their career after they've hit 50 years old. Man. It's just unheard
of.
Yeah,
it is unheard of.
What does rock bottom mean to you? Like, how far did you get?
I mean, I can't speak for Bobby, but you know, I think I hit rock bottom probably around 97.
I think that monitoring points to that about around 2005 or 6.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, all the drugs had gotten me so disjointed and my body was just ripped to shreds, and my faith in rock and roll had died finally. And when that spark goes out, that's the pilot light, right? The whole stove. Everything I do right comes back tenfold to me. Everybody in our band is clean, sober, 100%, all four members. I'm the only cigarette smoker in the band, and we take no drugs. And that's a big change from where we were, because we were known for the exploitation. You know, I mean, after Johnny Thunders died, I was the poster boy for narcotics abuse for many years, I think.
Frustrating thoughts within my brain. It's not too much that's keeping me sane. That cloud keeps hanging over my head. She's got me in a grip, I've been misled.
When I met my wife, it changed my life very, very drastically. And she said, you know, I see through the scars and the abscesses and the holes and the tracks and the this and the that. And I see a softness under there. And she stuck with me, you know, and we've been together 4 years now. We've been married about a year and a half, and she gave me a baby son too.
Oh, sweet. What's your son's name?
What do you think? His name's Bobby.
Junior?
Robert. But his middle name is not the same as mine. His middle name is Joseph, after my dad.
Uh-huh.
My dad's still alive, God bless him. He's 91. My wife is 24. Okay. And now the band's back together. We're having the most success far and above ever before in the whole 40-year history of Pentagram, and we do things right, and they come back to the nines. You know, so I just think people will keep listening. As long as they keep listening, it gives us a purpose to keep doing it.